Predicting Boston House Price Using Decision Tree Problem. This is regression problem, not classification. When we deal with classification problem, the evaluation is very easy. When you see this problem, we can easily know the accuracy is 60%. However, let's see this case. Using regression, I predict the value. When we compare actual value and predicting value, it is very similar. But when we get the accuracy score using classification method, the accuracy is very low. Even though the predicting value is very similar to actual value, but not just that value, the classification method said it's wrong answer. So we need another method in regression problem when we deal with accuracy. So there are three types of evaluation method in regression. First thing is correlation coefficient. When the value is close to 1, the trend is very similar. When the correlation coefficient value is 0, the trend is not similar. When you use this method, there are strengths. Very simple and intuitive. But there are also weakness. We don't know actual scale value. We just know the trend, tendency, not just value. Because even though the coefficient is very high, we can just say the tendency is very similar, but we do not guarantee we predict actual value. Another thing is mean squared error. Using the difference value of actual value and predicted value and square and mean value, we can get some value, MSE. Using that, we can know the exact difference between actual value and predicting value. Sometimes, the mean absolute error can be used. In this situation, the difference is just absolute value. Actual. So both are used widely. And the last thing is normalized mean squared error. There are weakness of the MSE. For example, we can get the value, MSE value 20. Is it big or not? When we deal with housing problem or stock problem, it is small, right? However, when the stock is very small stock, when the stock price move 10, 30, the value is very big. So following the problem, the value is so different. So to compensate that, we use the normalized MSE. Normalized MSE is the value which is MSE divided by max value. Or some guy use the mean value. Some guy use the difference between max and mean. There are lots of alternative, so when you use this one, you consider the situation and the specification of data, and then you can choose one. So there are three type of evaluation method. So when you evaluate or score the model, you can use it. Let's solve real code. This is the basic library and data set. We can load Boston housing data set, and we can make the price column using this one. So we can get the Boston housing data set. This is price. And then there are lots of input data. Crime rate, this is the number of the room, and age of house, tax, there are lots of input are needed. When we check the price column, there are lots of value here. When we deal with classification, there are small category of things are exist, but in regression problem, there are lots of target. Because all house price of a house is different, right? So input data and output data, and using the train test split, we can make train data and test data. So and then we import plot tree, and we import decision tree regressor, not classifier in this situation. So we made the model and then train or run the model. So there are score, the classification score, but the value is so low, right? So we can apply another method. First thing is correlation coefficient. We can compare the predict value and actual answer value. The correlation coefficient is 0.84. It's very high value. Of course, when we compare the score of classification and correlation of regression, there are lots of case regression is high because, classification is high because regression is much more hard to find the actual value and have high performance. Regression usually the hard work. And the second is MSE, mean square error. So you can import this mean square error. You can get 27. Is it high or not? We don't know that. So we adjust normalize mean square error. You can divided by the max value of the actual value, and you can also use another things. When you read the journal paper, so lots of so there are lots of guy use this one. So another lots of guy use this one. Another lots of guy use this one. So it is not determined. So you can use anything. So when we adjust normalized mean squared error, it's 1.22. So we can indirectly know the error is such bigger than max value. And then let's plot the plot tree, and it's very complicated, so we regulate the max depth so we can get three layer. When we write that there are lots of layer because the regression is much more complicated. So first standard is RM. It means number of the room, and then lots of standard comes out. Normal crime rate. So you can know the what is important feature to determine or increase or decrease the price of house in Boston. So when you type the feature importance, you can get lots of the weight or importance value. Using this one, you can get maximum column or maximum feature of the feature to determine the price of the house. So five column is the most important factor. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So when you type this one, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this command said when the price of Boston is determined, the number of room, so-called RM, is most important factor. So let's summarize. Differ from classification problem, we need another method to evaluate regression. So please remember it. And then when we solve this problem, we know the strengths of decision tree. Nowadays, the deep learning is most powerful and popular method. However, when we deal with the problem related with money, we should know why the value is determined like that. So even though this is the deep learning world nowadays, decision tree, the predicting the price using decision tree now maintaining nowadays and getting more popular.